If you thought it was dark brown before, wait till you see it now. It's definitely a white filter that has turned completely rust colored in the process of 2 weeks.
People living in one part of Collier County say their water was shut off again, and it's only getting dirtier. This filter turned from white to brown within days. This is how most of us are used to seeing tap water, crystal clear, but in Copeland, it is murky brown, and some neighbors say it's making them sick. NBC2's Ryan Arbogast continues his investigation into the dirty water that's contaminated with lead and E. coli.
It's been raining here in Copeland, and some residents tell me they're even considering putting out buckets to collect rainwater to drink. It's been nearly 8 months since a boil water notice put E. coli throughout this town's water system, and now they just want answers.
They don't give a about us.
Yellow and cloudy, smelling of rotten eggs, and contaminated with lead, copper, and E. coli, according to the health department. It's a fight for clean water that's been raging near the Fakahatchee Strand for nearly 8 months.
This community has been ignored by Collier County for far too long. Infrastructure is literally crumbling.
Longtime resident Haley Twiddell showed us this water filter she installed on her home after we first broke this story last week.
And if you thought it was dark brown before, wait till you see it now.
This is what it looks like Wednesday afternoon. Copeland residents say the problems with this rusted out water tank, which provides invaluable H2O to every home in the small town, started after a boil water notice in March. A test confirmed their worst fears in September, E. coli and more. Just yesterday, U.S. Water Service Corporation shut off the faucets, and the community is back to boiling.
The problem is still ongoing, and I hope for change, but it's something that we are going to be fighting for.
Residents across Copeland say the water is literally sending them to the emergency room. One mother tells us that her 2-year-old son tested positive for lead in his blood. And others shared these images, including one of Twiddell's newborn child.
I got a big old ranch I never had before. I got all behind my ear, all in my hair.
The small town has now reformed its civic association to hopefully put themselves back on the map. They plan on having a public meeting in November and are extending an invitation to U.S. Water Service Corporation, the Department of Health, and Waste Management.
We're still people. We still have kids.
The Florida Department of Health in Collier County tells me now this case is completely out of their hands. They've passed it off to the Department of Environmental Protection. Reporting local today in Copeland, Ryan Arbogast, NBC2.